Hello and welcome to SciJoy. Tim has a lathe and I've wanted to learn how to use it for a while, but I didn't have an excuse. And Mike Boyd was looking for guest hosts for his channel, which is all about learning a skill. He starts from the beginning and he counts how many hours it takes him to learn a skill.
Welcome to day one, hour zero, and I'm gonna learn how to use this lathe.
I decided I was gonna learn the skill of using a lathe, and in the end, I would have a threaded bolt. And this video is about what I learned about how the lathe actually works. The next one will be about threading. And the first thing you need to know about a lathe is safety stuff. It can really wreck you, so you should have your hair tied back, your sleeves should be up, and you shouldn't have anything loose. I watched too many videos on the internet about the things that could go wrong. One guy actually put his leg up on the edge of the lathe and it picked him up and threw him over. So, I mean, I don't think you would do that, but please tie back your hair and pull up your sleeves. And luckily, Tim was there when I was gesticulating too much.
Yep, and just watch your arm and neck chuck.
And he would tell me to keep my arms back. So that's the number one thing with lathe, is no lathe safety. And then number two is gears. Gears are the big thing that I learned about lathes. When we worked with our milling machine or our 3D printer, we had these cutting tools that would move or the print head that would move, and it was all controlled by computers, so we needed to know the X, Y, and Z. But with the lathe, everything's controlled by gears. At least ours was. There's no computer part to it at all. At the very front of the machine is the headstock. That's where the spindle is, and the spindle attaches to the part and spins around. And it spins because it's attached to gears and pulleys.
From the little bit that I've read and watched videos of, this is called the headstock, right? And the whole point of a lathe is that it turns this part, and whatever piece that's inside of it.
So what happens is you put a piece of material in a spindle, and a motor is going to spin your material, and you can move a cutting tool along and take away parts that you don't want. Just like with our milling machine, we had a hunk of metal and we were taking away any parts of the material that we didn't want to be in our finished product. But the difference is this one is spinning, and you can either spin it quickly or slowly. So if you want to spin quickly, you use front gear. If you want to spin slower, you disengage front gear and then you engage back gear. And that's what you're going to use for threading. You want it to be a little bit slower.
Yes,
okay.
Now see.
So it's locked in. Okay. And now this is all spinning.
Right. So what you do is when you decouple that, that's only part of it. When you go into back gear, you're bypassing this gear ratio.
Okay.
Right here.
So you're bypassing this shaft, and then we're going to this back one?
Right. So there's a lever on the left-hand side that moves that.
See.
Anything?
Yeah, a little bit. So this gear engages with that gear. So we pop that out to disengage this one, and then to engage that one, we pull.
There's a lever on the back.
Pull this?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Now this one's driving it.
Right, so if I, you can see now.
Yeah, the back one's now spinning, and this is spinning.
That'd be much slower than it was before.
Right, and if I open this door, so down here is the motor, and the motor is attached to this wheel down here, and doesn't look like the pulley's on it.
Yep, it's loose, so.
Is this what engages it?
Yep.
Trying with left hand is hard. Whoa.
There we go, yep. Yeah, so there's like a little spring over on this side that it moves and then pushes it down.
Okay.
And then the drive here.
So you have your part in there and it's spinning at a certain rate. Now you have to move your cutting tool. And you can either do this by hand or you can do it using something called power feed.
This is why I use power feed so it's not so jerky.
Then there's a saddle where you can put in your cutting tool and lock it in place.
The part goes in here and then you take the tool and you're gonna slide it towards the part that's spinning. And what do all these different knobs and switches do? So this is where the tool goes, right? So this probably locks in the tool.
If you want to move the cutting tool, you can either turn a knob and make it go the length of the bed, or there's a cross slide that goes perpendicular to the direction of the bed.
A cross slide. So it slides across.
So there's a lead screw that goes the length of the bed, and it's spun by the motor. And you can use a selector to decide if you want to go up and down the bed or if you want to go with your cutting tool across the bed.
This is that feed this way. And then down here, this is that power cross feed that we're talking about. That drives this one.
And then that one's threading.
Yeah, see, when you do that, it like drives this. You can't do anything.
If you want a thread, this was kind of a magical part. There's these selectors, how many threads per inch that you want, and you move them around, and it changes what gears you're using. And then you put a selector on the power feed that says, I'm gonna thread. And with all these gears, it figures out what rate should it be spinning the part, and what rate should it be moving the cutting tool for you to get the perfect threading.
The regular power feed is just proportional to whatever you have for that. And then the threading matters because it's going to do different pitch, like different numbers of threads, so it's going to be a different gear.
Right, so there's all the stuff is on here for the charts. There's a few gears in the back of behind the headstock on this side. So way over here is where those other gears are.
So that's a basic overview of what a lathe is and some of the different parts. There's way more parts, like there's a tailstock and all kinds of other stuff, but that's basic knowledge of how to use a lathe. In the next video, I'll show you how I created a bolt for the most part, pretty much just threaded it. I hope you had fun learning with us today, and I will see you next time.